You actually did a song called One Day, which is the soundtrack for a feature film, yeah?
Yeah, it was for the Zuzu Pets. I recorded that song a few months ago. It was for the soundtrack of Quest to Zoo. I'm not sure if you're familiar with the Zuzu Pets, but they're really popular toys here. And
yeah, my niece loves them. If listeners, if you haven't seen them, they're kind of amazing. You know, you just turn them on and they whiz around the place. They're kind of like little, would you say hamsters?
They're hamsters.
I love them.
It's so funny because they gave me this huge box of Zuzu Pets for my niece and my nephews. So,
oh, that Tessa, we have to get some of these sent in now to the studio, yeah?
Yeah, definitely.
Been doing a hottest celebrity body. We're trying to find out from our listeners who's got the hottest celebrity body, yeah?
Do you have any points of view?
come on. You've got to, we need your opinion.
Mm.
I don't know about hottest bodies, but I've always been a huge crush of Leonardo DiCaprio.
Oh yeah!
Like when I was when I first saw him on Titanic, I was like, oh my god! And I was like only five. I fell in love with him.
Really, at five? Wow, that's pretty. That's pretty early, but that's good. Yeah.
No, but I'm a big fan of Leonardo DiCaprio, and Gael Garcia Bernal, and I guess you could say hottest body goes to Scarlett Johansson for me. But
I love Scarlett Johansson, especially in the Avengers.
Yeah, she's amazing.
Just going behind the scenes a little bit at American Idol, what was the one thing that stood out for you more than anything else that you actually enjoyed about the show that you'll now remember 2 years further down the track? So it may have been hanging out with friends or the judges, Ryan Seacrest. What is the main thing that stood out for you?
Just being given the chance to experience opportunities that I've never expected to have been given before auditioning. I was able to travel to many different parts of the world and meet, you know, a few of my idols, like, you know, the lead singer of Muse, Math Bellamy, and Kate Hudson, Halle Berry, Muhammad Ali, Beyonce, Mandy Moore, Jack Black, Amanda Seyfried, and Adam Lambert.
You actually sang with Beyonce, didn't you? Is that right?
Yeah, it was a lot of fun.
Okay, so you're on stage with Beyonce here. I've been looking at your other stuff. You don't get nervous because I've been checking you out right through these auditions. It's like, I think the judges ask you, do you get nervous? And it's like, oh, not really. But when you're next to Beyonce on stage, is that like... Does anything happen, or it's just like, okay, I've really got to rock out this. I've got to do a good job here.
I mean, definitely, because we rehearsed for a few days. We tried to get our dance moves down, and when she came, I was extremely nervous because she was watching us the entire time, and I was just extremely embarrassed to, you know, get my booty shake on, you know, because it's her signature move and she's just right there, and it was extremely nerve-wracking. But you know, I was always a huge fan of Beyonce, but after meeting her I became an even bigger fan, just because she's so sweet and down to earth, and you know, it's nice to see that, you know.
And she gave you some advice as well, with obviously you rehearsed together as well before you jumped on live on TV. How was she for someone to give advice to you?
We didn't really have time to, you know, for her to give advice, but, just her being her is her advice alone, you know? And I look up to her just for staying so sweet and so humble. And, you know, that's why I say, you know, I'm such an even bigger fan of hers now, just because she's just, you know, for a person like her, you know, going through so much, in her career, to have stayed that, you know, humble, is just it's amazing, I think. So yeah,
thank you so much for joining us today on Behind the Talent. All the listeners out there, go and check Thia out on Facebook, obviously, and what's your Twitter address, Thia, as well, so we can get it out to the listeners?
It's twitter.com/TMegiaAI10.
Excellent. Keep in touch. And once again, thank you so much for joining us. And look after yourself.
Thank you so much, guys. You take care.
Okay, bye-bye.
Bye. She's amazing.
She's such a great chick.
So inspirational, especially everything she said about how much Beyonce inspired her and stuff. Like, and without even really getting that starstruck. Like, I find that inspirational, being able to stand next to Beyonce and not be starstruck.
She's 17. She's like, it's just funny how mature she is at like 17. Mm. 17, I was like down at the shop getting our mixed lollies and some chocolate.
Wow, you had a great teenage years, Yoram.
Okay, I'm going to actually head off to one of Thia's songs now. This is Thia Megia, One Day, from the soundtrack we just mentioned, Quest for Zoo. You're on Joy 94.9.
Nobody sheds a tear, let nobody has a fear.